turn back again on the same topic.
Narudia tena pakishina moya moya.
The bloodline case.
Malaana ya mudamu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say bloodline case.
Sema malaana ya mudamu.
When I want to talk on the bloodline case,
wakati napendelea kusema pa malaana ya mudamu,
I've got a reason.
Niko na raison.
On talking on it.
Pa kusemea pa hii.
Because I know.
Tumi najua.
Most people.
Bantu mingi
in our midst
katikati yetu
are into troubles.
Beko matatizo.
Lives
mamaisha
are not okay.
Haina mzuri.
They are leading a bad life.
Beko naongoza maisha mubaya.
They are living into a bad life.
Beko naishi mumaisha mubaya.
They are passing into more difficulties.
Beko napita matatizo mingi.
Peace is not together with
salama
them.
Salama haina pamoja nabo.
And the reason, let her tell you,
acha nikoneshe,
where does this case come from?
Wapi kule hii laana inatokea?
The case
laana
is into your blood.
Iko ndani ya damu yako.
The dwelling of the case.
Makao ya laana.
What you are seeing with your two eyes.
Ile uko naona na macho yako mbili.
Is in you.
Iko ndani yako.
It is written.
Imeshaandikwa.
It is written into your blood.
Banesha yandika mudamu
yako. And you,
na weye,
you start to live it.
Unaanza kuiishi.
No one,
hakuna mtu,
can live by the flesh.
Anaezi kuishi kwa mwili.
No,
apana.
Everyone,
mutu ote,
is living by the blood.
Eko naishi na damu.
Without the blood,
pasipo damu,
you can't live.
Awezi
but kuishi. With the flesh,
na mwili,
is nothing.
Ni bure.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Last time,
wakati ya zamani, mashiku ya kumukongo.
We'll read you and me.
Turisoma mweye na mie.
Into Leviticus. Chapter number 17
chapter
verse 11.
17 na verse
11. We'll read God.
Turisoma mungu.
Talking to Aaron.
Eko nasema na
and to Moses.
Na Musa.
And say.
Na nasema.
Talk to my people.
Sema na bantu yangu.
Admonish them.
Ubaverti.
That.
Ya kusema.
The life.
Maisha. Bushima.
The life of the flesh
bushima bwa mwili
is into the blood.
Buko mutamu.
This is the reason I put it
na iweka
on the altar
pa mazabau
for the atonement of souls.
Juu ya upatanisho wa nafsi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say atonement of souls.
Sema upatanisho wa manafsi.
The life of the body
uzima wa mwili
is into the blood.
Uko ndani ya
and
damu.
God take it
na Mungu anaibeba
and put it
na kuiweka
on the altar
pa mazabau
for the atonement
juu ya upatanisho wa manafsi.
It is to say what?
Ni kusema nini?
The soul
nafsi
to be atoned
juu ipatane
with the body
na mwili.
You must have.
Unapashwa kuya.
You must have something what they are calling atonement.
Unapashwa kuya na kintu moya kile banaita upatanisho.
The Bible say.
Biblia nasema.
Let us we create man.
Acha tuumbe mutu.
In our image.
Kwa mfano wetu.
You need to say they create you into
weye,
God's image.
Mumufano wa Mungu.
Now,
sasa,
after a time,
kisha wakati moya
they hivi, made a skeleton.
Banafanya skelet.
They made a flesh.
Bakafanya mwili.
What we are calling the human body.
Ile tukunaita mwili ya mwanadamu.
This human body.
Hii mwili ya mwanadamu.
God gave it.
Mungu akaipatia.
That this is the house.
Hii ni nyumba.
Now,
sasa,
what I created into my image,
ile niliumba mumufano wangu,
it was the soul.
Ilikuwa kani nafsi.
The soul
nafsi
must be
inapashwa kuya
living into the body.
Iko naishi mumwili.
Now, for the soul
asa njuya nafsi,
to live into the body,
iishi mumwili,
you must have
unapashwa kuya
a conjunctive. What they are called conjunction.
Unapasha kuya conjunction.
Kunapasha kuya conjunction. That conjunction.
Ile conjunction.
It has got a job.
Iko na kazi.
To atone.
Ya kuunga.
To atone the body and the soul.
Na nafsi.
And there will be another conjunction.
Na, kutakuwa conjunction ingine.
To atone.
Kupatanisha.
God
Mungu
and soul.
Na nafsi.
To be created into the image of God.
Kumbiwa mumufano wa Mungu.
Is it to say,
ni kusema,
God must come from somewhere.
Mungu anapaswa tokea fasi moja
hivi. And enter in you.
Na anaingia ndani yako.
But into the body.
Lakini ndani ya mwili.
God can't remain into the body.
Mungu hawezi kubaki ndani.
This is what they are reading.
Njoo bila banasoma.
They read what?
Wanasoma nini?
I God.
Mie Mungu.
Into Genesis chapter number 6.
Chapter number 6.
God is speaking what?
Mungu anasema nini?
I God.
Mie Mungu.
I want to strive with the human body.
Siwezi kuikala na mwanadamu.
Mu.
Siwezi kuikala ndani ya mwanadamu.
Because him too.
Tu na yeye.
Is the flesh.
Ni mwili.
I can't remain into the human being.
Siwezi kubakia ndani ya mwanadamu.
Because he is a flesh.
Tu yeye ni mwili.
It is to say in you a flesh. God can't remain in you.
Mungu hawezi kubakia ndani yako.
They are not dwelling.
Hamuna makao.
The reason they follow Jesus.
Ndio pale walifuataka Yesu.
They ask him questions.
Anamuuliza ulipo.
Where are you living?
Unekalaka wapi?
And they say, I don't have the dwelling.
Sina na makao.
Everything I got with dwelling.
Kintu kyote kinakaa na makao
mimi. I don't have.
Mimi sina nayo.
It is to say in you God won't remain in it.
Mungu hawezi bakia mule ndani.
Now, to make God to be with you.
Unaweza kufanya je Mungu akwe pamoja na wewe?
Because Emmanuel,
to Emmanuel
means
inamaanisha Mungu
with people.
Na bantu.
Now, if
kama
him,
yeye
as a Gerard
arilapaka,
I want to remain with you.
Sitabakiaka na wewe.
What can you do?
Sitekalaka
na wewe. I want to remain with you.
Sitekalaka na wewe.
What can you do?
Sasa utafanya nini?
For God remaining with you.
Tu Mungu ekale na wewe.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bloodline case.
Malana ya mudamu.
Bloodline case.
Sema na wewe malana ya mudamu.
Bloodline case.
Laana ya mudamu.
Are we together?
Eske tu pamoja?
Am I talking to you?
Eske niwezi kusema na wewe?
You see?
Unaona?
Prophecy.
Matabiri.
Want to change your life.
Haitashanjaka maisha yako.
We can prophesy on you. It won't change your life. We can do whatever, we can pray for you. It won't change your life. The secret is what? You must know the strategical position of your suffering. And if you cut it, you will see everything will be nice. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To prophesy on you, it is to tell you what you know.
Ni kukonesha kilo na yua.
If I've prophesied,
kama nilitabiri yako,
it was to convince you.
Ilikuyaka ni kukukonvincre.
That you know, God is together with us.
Na yua bien, kusema
but,
na
secret,
secret
is to know
ni kujua
what position,
ni position kani
your problems is passed on.
Mambo yako inesha kuikia. Kala.
Pale ma position kani mambo wako nisha kuikaria. Mambo wako nikala pa position kani. This is a great secret.
Injo secret munene.
Bloodline case.
Lana ya
now God is being what?
Asa Mungu wanasema
I want to remain with the people because they are flesh.
Ni mili.
Now, you too, for living a nice life, you must have God together with you.
Now,
him is being what? You are a flesh. I want to remain with you. But, if you turn back into the creation, he created a man into his image. It is to say, God was communicating with people by imagination.
Par imagination.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Imagination.
Imagination.
God Mungu was communicating.
Arianza kusumburiaka.
To communicate.
Arianza kucommuniquer.
Patana.
Arianza kupatanaka.
God was communicating with people.
Mungu arianza kupatanaka na bantu.
By what am I talking?
Imagination.
By imagination.
Kupitia imagination.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you sat down,
wakati unaikala chini,
and you continue to imagine it,
na unaendelea na kuimagine,
when you are imagining something,
wakati kuna imagine kitu moya hivi,
God him too
Mungu na yeye
is coming to you and communicating together.
Na munapatana pamoja.
You and him.
Weye na yeye.
This is the reason he said what?
Ndopala nasema nini?
Let I create people into my image.
Acha niumbe mtu ama acha niumbe bantu mumfano wangu.
And into the image of God,
na mumfano wa Mungu,
he created them.
Akabaumba.
And when he wants to visit them,
na wakati anapenda kubatembelea,
he's coming into imagination.
Anakuyaka mu imagination.
He did to say whatever you are imagining.
Ni kusema byote bile huko na imagine.
It is true.
Ni vya kweli.
Because of what? Through your imagination.
Kupitia imagination yako.
God is there. Because into imagination.
Mu imagination.
This is the place.
Injo fwashi.
What God say no is my image is similar to me.
Mule Mungu anasema ni mfano wangu ananifana mimi.
Now you into your imagination.
Mu imagination yako.
What are you imagining?
Uko na imagine nini?
Say to your neighbor, try to imagine.
Umaanisha vazia wako, pima kuimagine.
If you imagine,
kama una imagine,
bad thing,
kintu kibaya.
It is to say,
ni kusema,
you connect to God,
unachomeka Mungu,
to what you want to happen to you.
Kukilo napenda kikufikie.
There is a big difference between thoughts and imagination.
Panikala kati mnene sana katikati ya mawazo na imagination.
To think,
kuwaza.
You can be thinking,
unawaza.
But to imagine,
kuimagine.
It is another thing.
Ni kintu kingine.
What are you doing into your imagination?
Uko nafanya nini mu imagination?
What are you wishing to be?
Uko nataka kuya nini?
Imagine to be what and you will become it.
Imagine kuya fulani na utakikuya.
Are we together?
Eske tuko pamoya?
Even if you are sick,
ata kama uko malari,
try to imagine.
Pima kuimagine.
That I am well.
Ya kusema niko mujima.
Niko tu bien.
Niko tu bien.
And you will see.
Na utaona.
You become well.
Unakuwa bien.
Because what?
Juu ya nini?
Through your imagination.
Kupitia imagination
yako. You will become what you are imagining.
Utakuya kile uko na imagine ndani yako, ndani yako, ndani yako.
If I said today,
kama nasema leo,
I can go in South Africa.
It is true you will go to South Africa. Africa.
Through imagination.
Kupitia imagination yako.
Now if your imagination,
imagination
is
yako,
no good, you won't go anywhere. Who has got the book, that book? Have you got it there? Is it ready?
Kiko tayari pale.
Read it.
Soma kyo.
Verse 5.
Verse 5.
Five.
Five.
You don't know.
I would do it.
L'Éternel vit que la méchanceté des hommes était grande sur la terre et que toutes les pensées de leur cœur se portaient chaque jour uniquement vers le mal.
Are you getting it?
Unashikia.
And God saw
na Mungu akaona
that the wickedness of man
mawazo ya
bubaya
bwa mtu,
the wickedness of man
bubaya bwa mtu,
was great in the heaven.
Ulikuwa kabunene sana mudunia.
Unakuwa bubaya sana, unakuwa bunene sana bubaya mudunia. And that every imagination, it is where there is my problem. That every water, every
kila
water,
nini, kila nini,
we, are we together?
Eske tuko pamoya?
Every water,
kila nini,
that the letter first, every water. And God saw that the wicked of the human being, letter first, and God saw that the wicked of the human being become create. And every imagination. And every
imagination.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Huh? And every
imagination.
God saw that the wicked greatness of the man was great, and every imagination was only going continually to the birds. Bwana kaona ya kuwa upaya wa mtu ulikuwa mkubwa. Kisha na mawazo yake ninshi amapange. In Kiswahili it is not there, but in Bemba amapange. Eh? And every
kupanga
amapange.
Amapange.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are we together, elders? In so what and what? Aronani na nini?
Naona ubaya wa mwanadamu unakuwa bunene sana. Sasa tena sasa na wako na amapange.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Shout the greatest hallelujah. Shout it. In so the wickedness of the human being was great, and every imagination was continually set on the evil thing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I say no. Yes. The imagination of the human being is bad. I want to remain with him because he is a flesh. Because a flesh has got only a bad imagination. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is it true? Is it true? God saw that the human being become more wicked. And he said what? Let I control. If he is bad, perhaps his imagination is good. And if so, even the imagination was bad, and God said no, I want to remain with him. Imagination was good, God could remain together with you. This is the problem. When you are living to approach God, if you want God to be with you, have a nice imagination. If your imagination is good, even if the body is bad, no problem. God is not depending on the body. Say to yourself, God is not depending on the body. Say to yourself. God is not depending on the body. Are you talking to God is not depending on the body. He's depending on the imagination. What are you imagining? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Shout. When he saw that the wickedness of the man beyond the levels, he said, no problem. Let I control his imagination. Going to the imagination, in fact, the major imagination, he was only speaking to the evil. I will die. I will suffer. I'm not good. I will fall down here. And God said, what is this? What is this? Who is this one? He has got the bad sides to himself. He's a flesh. Starting today, I won't be with him. And is he yes? Will he remain 120? It is done. Now, if you want to live a long time, take your imagination. Take Break your imagination. Connect it to God. Because it is the imagination. What is showing that you are to the image of God. Into imagination. There is a word. What they are calling image. Let me create people. To my image. It is to say. I will start to visit them. Into imagination.
Imagination.
I can be here. I say no, Father. Let I prophesy to you. You to say, I start to imagine. What is the life of this man? I go into the realm of the spirit. I see this and that and that and that. It is to say, I connect to the imagination. And that imagination, we call it prophecy. And you see, it is true. It is true. It is to say, it is a spiritual imagination. Where we connect to God, and we connect to you, and we imagine. After imagining, we found it is true. And you say, Dad, yes, it is true. It is true. This is true. This is true. What is true? Whatever you are speaking. Even your sickness. If you imagine, you say, no, I become good. It is to say, you will become good today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are dying by imagination.
Tunakufaka par imagination.
And, we are alive by imagination.
Tuko bajima par imagination.
You imagine bad, you live bad. You imagine good, you live good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is what we are speaking. There are some bloods. Those bloods, they are only imagining bad things. Because of what? Gentiles. What we are calling giants was there. They took wives. They begot children. They took their blood. They put it into generations. After putting it into generations, those people start to grow up. It is to say the people have bad imagination. Those people got so that they had got a bad imagination. Direct them to. They begot children. After giving birth to more people, those people, they receive chromosomes, blood, and a kind of group of blood. And those people, even today, they are there. And the reason I say, the bloodline case, it is a curse what came from those giants. Those giants begot the children. And the children are here today. Our forefathers, our ancestors, is your father whom you inherit through him the blood. That blood you've got. Now this blood has got a bad imagination. Now the reason God is not visiting you. You want God to visit you. Take this blood out. As you sang,
out.
You say what? Out. And you answer? I'm not getting you.
Out.
Yes.
Laana mkizazi. Out.
Amen. Not in the family, into the blood.
Hapana mufamili, mudamu. Laana ya mudamu. Out. Laana ya mudamu. Out.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you say,
come on,
my blood,
damu yangu.
There is a case of those Nephilim.
Ya pale ba Nephili.
It was what case? What case?
Imagination.
Bad imagination.
Ya imagination.
Bad imagination.
Imagination mubai.
And God said no. Because they are imagining only bad things. I want to be with them. I can't help them. Now, if you want God to help you, imagine good.
Imagine
and you will see God will help you. It is a simple thing. A simple one. To arrange and the problem finish. Say yes, I will imagine. Alléluia.
Amen.
C'est tout le débat. I will imagine.
Minta imagine.
If I imagine to become your pastor, tomorrow I become your pastor.
Kama na imagine kuya pasteur wako, kesho nitakuwa pasteur wako.
If I say no, I imagine
to
dominate this man. And tomorrow, I will dominate upon you. Because of what? My imagination. It is my way God is visiting people. You are bad imagining. You know that and God too
won't
be with you because what? Your imagination is bad.
Say,
bad imagination,
imagination mupaya,
is a bloodline curse.
Ni laana ya mudamu.
Even if you are sick,
ataka mungu malaya,
don't think about death.
Ushuwaze lufu.
You are only,
oh, apana,
I can die.
Mine sikufa.
You see,
unaona?
People, here
tu,
I am. Prophet, the time I am alive.
Apa niko mujima.
Hear this and that.
Mushikiri.
Because you are imagining,
juku
you die.
Imagine.
That is Jonathan. Even if you
Papa
are,
Jonathan,
you are that, you become
kilo na
old. Don't think that you will die tomorrow.
Ushuwaza kusema utakufa.
Don't imagine.
Ushimagine kusema ni kufa kesho. Hapana kuimagine.
You won't die. You can be walking, you are like this. And I think I'm no good.
Now,
don't imagine to
die.
It is normal, I can walk like this.
Normal.
And people, they say, we don't know tomorrow, we don't know. No problem.
I know, mom.
Them, they don't know, but I am imagining
I am alive.
I don't have money. I know that I've got it. This church, we built it by imagination. There was no money, there was no what, but imagination only that law. We shall have a church here at this place and it will become like this imagination. And when the imagination become realized, we call it prophecy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The prophecy
Matabiri
is the result
ni resultat
of the imagination.
Ya imagination.
If
kama
the imagination,
imagination
is realized,
inakuwa realize,
it becomes a prophecy.
Inakuya prophecy.
Are you looking for the prophecy?
Ukona tafuta prophecy.
Imagine first.
Imagine mbele.
Imagine first.
Imagine mbele.
And after having this imagination,
natisha kuwa na hii imagination,
yes, the word will come upon
neno
it.
Neno itakuwa yulu ya
and you become alive.
Na unakuya mujima.
I know you hear.
Na yua unasikia.
Na you sang that.